And welcome back friends in the YouTube channel S Botany, which is dedicated for the undergraduate botany students. So we are dealing about the flower, and next one part is the floral holes. So within a flower, two kinds of the floral holes are present. One is accessory hole, while one is a essential hole or a non-essential and essential hole, or vegetative and reproductive hole. In vegetative hole, non-essential hole or accessory hole, there are two floral holes are present. One is a calyx and another one is a corolla. Just see about the first one hole, which is called as a calyx. So calyx is the outermost hole of the flower. An individual member of this calyx is called as a sepal. So it is known as accessory or non-essential hole. Sepals, as they are present at the outermost level, they are generally green in color, and therefore they protect the flower in bud condition, or they provide protection to the inner holes of the flower, like corolla, androecium, as well as gynoecium. In some cases, as it is green in color, it also participates in the process of photosynthesis. Calyx show variations in their shape, size, color, and duration. Just see the nature of the calyx. These calyx, or the individual member of the calyx, may be free or united. When the sepals are free, then they are called as a polysepalous, while when the sepals are united, when the sepals are fused, then the term used gamosepalous. So here broadly, poly means free, while gamo means united, and sepalous, that means sepals. When all sepals are completely free from each other, then the calyx is known as a polysepalous. Example, mustard or brassica. While gamosepalous condition, when the sepals are united, either partially or completely, then the calyx is known as a gamosepalous calyx. Example, hibiscus. Just see the modifications present in the calyx. So the calyx or sepals modify for various functions as per the need of the plant, bringing various modified forms of the calyx, and these modifications may be either petalar calyx, maybe the papous calyx, or maybe the spurred calyx. Just see one by one what is the difference between the papous calyx, petalar calyx, and spurred calyx. What is petalar calyx? Petaloid, petal-like. Okay, petaloid, petal-like. That means when the calyx are petal-like, corolla-like, then it is called as a petaloid calyx. Okay, so when sepals look like petal, then they are called as a petaloid calyx. Again, one of the sepal from the calyx hole become large, white color, or variously colored, and attractive one like the petal, then it is called as a petaloid sepal. Okay, so what is petaloid calyx? When sepals looks like the petal, or when one of the sepal from the calyx hole becomes colored like the petal, then it is called as a petaloid calyx. So if you see here this one image, here this one is the corolla hole, or these are the petals. Well, these are the sepals. Usually sepals are outermost and they are green in color, but you will see here these are colored one, and usually these are observed in the family Cisalpinaceae. Okay, so पेट्रोलॉइड कैलिक्स, हियर एग्जाम्पल इज ए म्यूसेंडा. जैसे अपन तो पैपस कैलिक्स, दिज आर द पैपस कैलिक्स, सी हियर दिज आर द फीदरी और हेयर लाइक स्ट्रक्चर. व्हेन द कैलिक्स इज मॉडिफाइड इनटू हेयरी और स्केली और फीदरी स्ट्रक्चर देन इट इज कॉल्ड एज ए पैपस कैलिक्स. दीज पैपस कैलिक्स रिमेन अटैच टू द ओवरी और व्हेन द ओवरी बिकम्स द फ्रूट दीज पैपस कैलिक्स अटैचेस और रिमेन अटैच टू द फ्रूट एंड दे हेल्प इन द डिस्पर्सल ऑफ दिस फ्रूट. हेयर दिस पैपस कैलिक्स एक्ट्स एज ए पैराशूट. ओके, सो व्हेन द सेपल्स आर हेयरी फिदरी और स्केल लाइक देन दे आर कॉल्ड एज ए पैपस कैलिक्स एंड यूजली ऑब्जर्व इन फैमिली अस्टरासी. इन सम केसेज दे आर ऑल्सो ऑब्जर्व इन द फैमिली इफ और वी ए सी. हेयर एग्जाम्पल इज ए ट्राडक्स प्रोकुम्बेंस. स्पर्ड कैलिक्स, वन ऑफ द सेपल, सी हियर दिस इज ए आउटरमोस्ट होल ऑफ द कैलिक्स. वन ऑफ द सेपल फ्रॉम द कैलिक्स होल इज प्रोलॉन्ग्ड डाउनवर्ड into a tubular structure which usually stores the nectar is called as a spur. So this one is the spur, and if such a kind of a spur is present then the calyx is called as a spur calyx. So example is a impedance, example balsam. So this is about the modification of calyx. Next one hole we have to see is a corolla. So corolla is a second hole of the flower, most attractive hole of the flower, and individual members are called as a petal. Usually the color of the flower is decided by the color of this corolla. So corolla is a second accessory hole and is made up of petals. It protects the inner hole of the flower. Which are the inner hole? Actually the reproductive hole, in which hole of androecium and gynoecium is present. So corolla protect the androecium as well as gynoecium. Petals are usually brightly colored because of the presence of water soluble pigment anthocyanin, anthoxanthin, or maybe the carotenoid. In some flower, corolla emit odor and the scent of essential oil make the color make the flower more fragrant or highly attractive. Corolla plays a significant role in the pollination as it is a colored one. It attracts the pollinating agent and therefore it plays significant role in the process of pollination. What is pollination? Transfer of pollen grains from anther to stigma. This is the pollination, and for the attraction of the pollinating agent the corolla play a significant role. Just see sepaloid petals. This is a one of the modification present in the corolla hole. Sepaloid petal, sepal like petal. It is just like the petaloid sepals. Okay, petal like sepals. Here sepal like petal, when the petals are green like the calyx hole then they are described as a sepaloid petals. Example is Artabotris or Anona. Then next one is a clawed petal or clawless petal. In a petal the lower portion is normally narrow like a stalk of the leaf and is known as a claw. So if you see, this is a hole of a corolla. You can observe this one is a corolla, this one is a corolla. If you see the individual petal, then this individual petal may be appear in this way. When this petal shows such a type of a petiole like structure and upper broad region, this upper broad or flattened region is called as a limb region, while this stalk like region is called as a claw. If such a type of a claw present in the petal, then such a type of petals are called Clawed petals. And when such a type of a claw absent, when the petal looks in this way, here is a here claw is absent, therefore such a type of a petals are called clawless petals. Okay, so here clawed petal. So two typical parts are present in the petal. One is a claw and another one is a limb. Okay, so this is a portion of the limb and this is a portion of the claw. Okay, just see about the corolla hole. So sepaloid corolla, clawed petal. In a petal, the lower portion is normally narrow, like the stalk of the leaf. And this stalk-like structure of the petal is called as a claw. And when such a type of a claw is present, then that petal is called as a clawed petal. Otherwise, the petal is called as a clawless petal. The swollen expanded part of the petal is called as a limb. If this one is a claw, this one is the portion of the limb. Okay, so the swollen expanded portion of the petal is called as a limb. Okay, then next one is a corona. The petals form hair-like outgrowth, which is known as a corona. Suppose this one is a gamopetalous condition, sorry, gamopetalous condition, or just see this one figure. Okay, such a type of a gamopetalous condition. This one is a corolla tube and this one is a corolla lobe. When the junction of the tube and lobe is called as a throat. Okay, and at the throat region, when such a type of a scale like or hair like structure is present, then it is called as a corona, usually observed in the plant Nerium one. Okay, so what is corona? The petal here, the petals form hair like outgrowth, which is known as a corona. So these are the hair like outgrowth which are present in the throat region of the corona. Then the corolla may be regular or may be irregular. When it is regular, then it is generally considered as a actinomorphic or radially symmetrical. Or when it is irregular or zygomorphic or bilaterally symmetrical, the corolla may be polypetalous or gamopetalous. Same word used as in the in case of the calyx, gamopetalous and polypetalous. Here poly means free and gamo means united. When petals are free from each other, the corolla is called as a polypetalous one, and when the petals are united, then the corolla is said to be gamopetalous. You can observe these figures here. So this one is the condition. Here petals are completely free from one another, then this one condition is a polypetalous. While if you see these corolla, you will observe that petals are united. So when the petals are united, then the term gamopetalous is used, and when petals are free, then the term polypetalous is used. Okay, just see the forms of the corolla. There are different forms of the corolla, and which may be either regular or irregular, maybe the gamopetalous or maybe the polypetalous. Just see, these are the figures which showing the different types of the corolla. So just see this one figure. This is a cruciform type of a corolla. Okay, what is cruciform type of corolla? If you see here four petals are present, first, second, third and four. Okay, so four petals are present. All petals are free and corolla is a regular. Okay, so cruciform type of corolla is a polypetalous, three petals, regular one. All the petals are of same shape and size. Here petals are present completely right angle to each other. They form a cross-like structure. Then it is called as a cruciform type of a corolla. Okay, so first one figure indicating the cruciform type of a corolla. What is cruciform corolla? In this case, corolla is a regular. It is a polypetalous and actinomorphic. Okay, so corolla is a regular, polypetalous and actinomorphic. It consists of how many petals? Four free petals. Okay, so these are the four free petals. The four petals are in right angle to each other in the form of cross, then it is called as a cruciform corolla. Each petal has a claw and limb, then this one is called as a cruciform corolla and usually observed in a cruciferae family. Example is a Brassica. Next one is a papilionaceous type of corolla. So this one figure is a papilionaceous type of a corolla. In papilionaceous type of corolla, axillary type of distribution is present. This one is again polypetalous but irregular type of a corolla. Five petals are present, and out of these five petals, one is a largest one, which is called as a standard. It encloses two petals, they are called as wings, and again these two petals encloses again innermost two petals. They are generally considered as a cilia, which are fused at their margin. So this one is a largest one. This one is called as a standard. It encloses these two petals. They are called as wings, and again wings encloses two petal. They are called as a cilia. So if you see here, this one largest one is called as a standard. This standard encloses these two petals. They are called as a cilia, and again these two, which are fused at their edge or margin, they are called as a cilia. So this one is a gamopetalous, irregular, papilionaceous type of corolla, and a characteristic feature of family Papilionaceae, which is a subfamily of Leguminosae. So corolla is a irregular, polypetalous and zygomorphic. Consists of five petals, of which outermost petal is the largest and is known as a standard or vexillum. Two lateral petals partially covered by vexillum are two wings of a butterfly called the wings or ali. The two innermost petals are united to form a boat-shaped cavity, and these are the smallest and are known as a cilia or carina. This corolla is a characteristic feature of family Fabaceae or Papilionaceae. Example is a Clitoria. Just see about the infundibuliform type of a corolla. So this one is a figure of infundibuliform type of a corolla. What is infundibuliform type of corolla? This one is again a regular and gamopetalous type of a corolla. Regular, this is a funnel shaped or infundibuliform type of corolla. Regular, then gamopetalous type of corolla. Usually the number of petals are five. Here the fused petals form a funnel shaped structure. So such a type of a corolla is present and with looking like a funnel shape. That's why it is called as a funnel shaped corolla. At the base, the corolla is somewhat not showing so much build, but as you go towards the upper side, it broadens and forms a shape of a funnel, and that's why it is called as a funnel shape or infundibuliform type of corolla. So infundibuliform type of corolla or funnel shape corolla is a regular gamopetalous and actinomorphic. 5 petals unites together, corolla forms the funnel shape. When petals are united to form a tube and gradually widens upward, then the corolla is called as a infundibuliform type of corolla. And characteristic feature of family Solanaceae, example Datura or Ipomea. The next one is a bilipped corolla, or this one is also called as a bilabiate type of corolla. So this one figure represent the bilabiate type of corolla, or this one again represent the bilabiate type of corolla. So this one is a gamopetalous and irregular type of a corolla. Gamopetalous, irregular corolla, and usually form by means of 5 petals, where it forms 2 leaped structure or bilabial, upper one and lower one. Okay, so upper one leaf is usually formed by means of union of 2 petals, while lower leaf is formed by means of union of 3 petals. This condition may be 2 by 3 or maybe 3 by 2, but 2 leaf like structure or bilabiate, 2 lobes are formed, that's why it is called as a bilabiate or 2 leaped corolla or bilipped corolla. So it gives appearance of 2 lips of the mouth. Okay, the lip of the corolla is divided into upper portion and lower portion, which are called as a lip or labia. Upper lip consists of 2 petals, while the lower lip consists of 3 petals, and the mouth of corolla remains wide open. Then it is called as a bilabiate or bilipped corolla, and usually observed in family Lamiaceae or Labiatae. Examples are Osimum, Leucas, Adaptoda vesica. Okay, just say about the tubular corolla. Tubular corolla is a regular and gamopetalous. Okay, just see this one figure. This is a tubular corolla. What is tubular corolla? If you see this one figure, this one is a gamopetalous plus it is a irregular type of a corolla. Usually 5 petals are present, and all these 5 petals unite and form a more or less equally widened type of a tubular structure. Then it is called as a tubular corolla. So it just form a completely parallel tube-like structure of the corolla tube. Therefore, it is called as a tubular corolla. And one more is a bell-shaped corolla, or this one corolla is also called as a campanulate type of a corolla. What is campanulate corolla? This campanulate type of corolla is again regular type of corolla. And this one is a gamopetalous. Gamopetalous and regular usually form by means of 5 petals. The base of this corolla is so much narrow, and it widens upward, forming a bell-like structure. That's why it is called as a bell-shaped corolla or campanulate corolla. So campanulate corolla or bell shaped corolla, petals unite and corolla looks like a bell. Important thing, this one is regular and gamopetalous. Tubular corolla is also regular and gamopetalous, where the petals unite to form a short cylindrical tube like structure with small lobes, as present in the disc florets of Ostraceae family. Example is marigold or triadax, helianthus or sunflower. While campanulate or bell-shaped type of corolla is present in Cucurbitaceae members, example Cucurbita. Then just see what are the significance of the corolla. First one, it protects the essential whole of the flower in a bud condition as well as after maturity of these reproductive parts. Due to attractive color and sweet smell, the pollinating agent get attracted towards the corolla and they help in the process of pollination. Petals of the corolla are of various shapes and size, hence they give attractive shape to the flower, and the flower becomes conspicuous because due to the bright colored corolla. Next one part of the flower, which is generally considered as a vegetative part of the flower, is the perianth. The flower in which calyx and corolla is not differentiated, then the floral holes are known as a perianth. Okay, when calyx and corolla are not differentiated, then it is called as a perianth. Example, tubule. Member of the perianth is called as a tepal. Just the sepals are the members of the calyx, petals are the members of the corolla. The same way, tepals are the member of the perianth. When perianth is free, then it is called as a polyphyllous. While when they are fused, then they are called as a gamophyllous. Generally, the term use polytepalus or gamotepalus, but they are technically not correct. So, poly means free, gamo means united, and instead of tepal, phyllous term is used in case of the perianth. So, when the petal, when the tepals are united, then they are called as a gamophyllous condition, and when tepals are free, then they are called as a polyphyllous. So this is about the non-essential or accessory hole of the flower. In the next video, we will see about the reproductive hole of the flower. Till then, have a nice day. Goodbye.